So CD Projekt Red has now announced that Cyberpunk, well, seems like you're going to be able to customize your junk in the game. Oh, man. This is going to be interesting. Hey, what is going on, everybody? How are you all doing today? I hope you all are having a wonderful and fantastic day today. And if not, hopefully you all will have a better tomorrow. So, apparently, when it comes to customizing your character in Cyberpunk 2077, you're going to be able to customize everything, and that includes your junk. So, a lot of people were taking to Twitter, a lot of people were celebrating over this, stating you can customize your junk in Cyberpunk 2077. It's very interesting. I mean, personally, I'm excited for this game. I think that it's going to be very good. And in the game, they're going to give you sliders to adjust the size of your junk. And if you were to look through this right now, there are tons of game journalists that are just doing what many people would have obviously noticed, which, you know, they're up in arms about this. Cyberpunk 2077 allows gamers to customize their own junk. Cyberpunk 2077 ESRB rating, so much hornier than Final Fantasy VII Remake. Cyberpunk 2077 lets you customize your own junk. You know, you're seeing a lot of the same things from them. They're celebrating over this. You know, Cyberpunk 2077 will include customizable junk possible crucifixion. It's kind of ironic, though, because I'm going to get to another point about the hypocrisy of journalists and, you know, when it comes to anime games. But we'll get to that in just a moment. But let's go over everything in terms of what we know is going to be going on with the game. So there was a rating summary as to why it was rated as highly as it was. I think everybody expected it to be M rating anyways, or ESRB rating of 18 plus, you know, in other countries that have that rating as well. You know, it's very high up there. But like I said, I don't think anybody was surprised with that. So let's go ahead and talk about this, talk about the features that are going to be in Cyberpunk 2077. So this is a first-person RPG shooter in which players assume the role of a mercenary named V, trying to make their way through the open world at Night City. Players can explore futuristic locations, interact with citizens, perform missions, and engage in combat to complete various objectives within a storyline. Characters use handguns, machine guns, rifles, and explosives during frenetic firefights, and humans and cybernetically enhanced enemies. Players can also use melee weapons, wrist-mounted blades, enhanced limbs, to stab enemies and, in some cases, dismember them. Combat is frenetic with frequent gunfire, cries of pain, explosions, and blood splatter effects. Some locations depict mutilated corpses and open chest cavities and or exposed organs entrails. Now, this is sounding pretty interesting, yet as me. I am quite intrigued by this. During one quest, players assist a character by hammering nails through his hands and feet. Screaming sounds and blood effects accompany the scene. See, this is the thing I like. They're not afraid to take the extra mile. I like this. This is pretty cool. The game contains nudity and some fun time material. Players can select a gender and customize their character. Customization can include depictions of the breast, buttocks, and junk. So, see, there it is. As well as various sizes and combinations of junk. Players can encounter events where they have the option to engage in some fun time activities with other main characters or even, you know, workers of the night. These brief fun scenes from a first-person perspective. Oh, so that, yeah, that's even first-person perspective. Oh, wow. All right. Depict partially nude characters moaning suggestively while moving through various positions. Some scenes contain brief depictions of thrusting motions. Other scenes depict a character's head moving towards a partner's crotch. Well then, the game contains frequent depictions of references to fictional drugs, including characters taking puffs/hits of a stoic-altering inhaler stimulant. An animated billboard ad depicts a man snorting speed. Some sequences allow the player to drink alcoholic beverages repeatedly until the screen distorts. Players' characters can also drive cars while drunk. the words F and C appear in the dialogue. Okay, well, we knew that from the trailer, so that's not anything new, really. But from what we're hearing here, this is very interesting. This sounds really cool. Now, the one thing that a lot of people were really concerned about was, could CD Projekt Red be going woke here? But no, they're not. Because, okay, let me explain this one also. Unlike certain game studios, you know, what's different here is that this is about your experience, your choice, how you're going to play the game. It's not like where, you know, you have studios that force you to play as Ma'am, and, you know, you have to go as Ma'am throughout the game. You know, you get to customize your character however you like. And that's not pandering, because, you know, people are going to choose whatever they want to choose in terms of the character, as well as customize them however they like. You know, this game is supposed to be about what it's like to be human, you know, and the more you see, like, these components and pieces when it comes to the body, you know, does that make one human, right? So, really, that's different than what it would be like if they were to force you to play a said character that's Ma'am, you know, through a game. So, no, this is not woke. This is not pandering, and I think that this is actually a great idea, really, because, you know, it allows people to have their own experiences and play the game however they like, and that's the good thing, and they're not pushing agendas down your throat, you know, like some studios. Naughty Dog! you know, I'm just saying. But, you know, a lot of people were actually pretty happy about this. There were some people that were actually concerned. I mean, if you look at some of the tweets here, you know, like, look at IGN, for example, you know, they're like, players can select the gender and customize their Cyberpunk 2077. Character customization can include depictions of breast, buttocks, and junk, as well as various sizes and combinations and of junk. Now, I'm all for this idea. I think that this is going to be cool. I think this is going to be awesome to experience the game however you like. And it tries to help you question what it's like to be human. I mean, you know, what makes someone human? I think that's pretty interesting. But there were people that had concerns. This is what they were saying. Combinations of junk. Really? Don't do a Naughty Dog, please. Now, see, while this person is very scared of that, it's not going to do any harm. This other person responded by saying, how does combinations of junk harm anyone is anyway? I think that's a typo. How is your experience with the game tarnished in any way by options you can ignore? See, that's the thing. You can ignore options that you wouldn't want to see in the game. See, that's the cool thing. Like I said, it's just coming down to your own experience and playing how you'd like to play. I think that that's a good thing. And CD Projekt Red, the good thing about them is they listen to their fan base. And I think that's a good thing that other companies like, you know, Bethesda or EA or Naughty Dog or many others that I could bring up should be doing, rather than trying to do the stupid stuff they actually do. So CD Projekt Red does have a good record of listening to their audience. And, you know, there were people that were coming in saying this, which this tweet was good. Justin Wang stated, is it possible for me to give my character both assets and just one boob? Oh, man, I think that's funny. And another person, this was great. I love this one. Aw, yeah, can't wait to make my cyborg food a waifu. Oh, that's great. Another one saying, I'm making that booty thick. Oh, man. You know, it's just like people are actually coming up with some pretty cool statements and stuff. I have to say, pretty funny stuff. But, you know, everybody's celebrating over this. Now, when it comes to hypocrisy of journalists, I do want to bring this one up, as I stated I would. Thing is, journalists are celebrating, right? Well, this person brings up the point to think that game journos were offended about butt boob sliders in anime games and Conan. Yeah, see, that's the thing. You know, it's funny that they are praising Cyberpunk 2077 for this, but then if it comes to an anime game because, like, you know, you can pet the waifu or, you know, whatever, they immediately just hate on it for whatever reason. It's absolutely ridiculous stuff. It shows the hypocrisy of game journalists. And, you know, no one's surprised a game journalist would react that way. But here's what I have to say here, is that CD Projekt Red, I think they understand their fan base, they listen to them, and that's a good thing. This is something that game companies should be doing, is listening to their fan base, rather than trying to push their agendas, rather than trying to push all this woke crap onto people. They should be listening to the fans and delivering a good, polished game for everyone to enjoy. And I think that with this, I support what they're doing here, because they're trying to make the experience however you want in the game. You know, you get to choose how you play the game. And I think that's a good thing, and that's something I can get behind. And I have to say, CD Projekt Red, you're doing good, because I personally am looking forward to Cyberpunk 2077. But anyways, let me know what you think about this entire situation down below. Subscribe to the channel if you were new here. And make sure you were still subscribed, because YouTube is unsubscribing people from all their favorite channels. So make sure you were still subscribed to all your favorite channels. Hit the video with a like, and also be sure to share the video on social media. Spread the word and get it out there. It's greatly appreciated, and it really helps out the channel a lot. Also, be sure to follow me on Discord. We have a wonderful community there. Not only that, but it will keep you up to date on when the newest videos will be released, as well as any other upcoming events in the near future. So be sure to follow me on Discord. The link is in the description down below. But anyways, I hope you all have yourselves a wonderful and fantastic day today. And remember, if today was not a good day, tomorrow could always be better. Take care of yourselves and everyone around you. And have yourselves a good one out there, everybody.